Semi-finals. It's been a really exciting quarterfinal round. As you can see, in three out of those four quarterfinals were seven gamers and two, you know, with just 1 point separating those who advanced and those who did not. This match is between Mark Hazinski, currently living in Plano, Texas, 2004 Olympian and many-time U.S. men's national team member, versus Micaiah Skolnick, who caused one of the bigger upsets in this tournament by taking out number three seed Fernando Yamazato, 11-9 in the seventh. This was a really great match for Micaiah, and we'll see if he can keep the momentum up in the semifinal. You know, Mark is probably looking to avenge his loss in the elite singles semifinal and really hoping to take home this title.
Selected to serve for 0-0.
Starting off this game with some amazing forehand counter-looping rallies. This is going to be a great match.
Chop! 0-2.
And Mark's sometimes a slow starter, so don't ever count him out in the beginning. And Micaiah playing hot all day long, proving that he deserves to be here.
That's awesome. 4-0.
Beautiful backhand by Micaiah, running out to a good, solid 5-0 lead in this first game. Uncharacteristic miss by Mark on that big forehand shot.
Sorry.
6-2.
Running away with this first game 9-3, playing really fast and really forcing Hazinski to wake up and turn on his best game for this.
10-3.
I think Mark just needs to prepare for this ball to come back. You can't fall into the same trap that Fernando did, which may be underestimating Micaiah. Beautiful serve returns and some great points. Started with game two here in this semifinal match. I think Mark is taking
one
a strategy that may be to change the rhythm and slow it down. The Skolnick players are great at playing super fast, and I think this would be the right thing to do for Mark in order to get through Micaiah. Beautiful play, a little bit of a whiff from Micaiah. But again, this is a really strong match and really proves the depth of experience and of the players we have here at the St. Louis Open. Great spectator points as well. By both players. Awesome big forehand.
Three, four.
Okay, playing really strong. Really keeping up with Mark on all of the big points. It's now going to be who can play the short game better, who can think better and play the better strategy. At this point, it looks like both are equally matched on their ability to make great shots.
5, 4.
Ability to continue barraging him with those shots. So this is something that Micaiah does really well, and it shouldn't come to a surprise. There's definitely a reason why Micaiah is in the semifinals. He did force that upset against Fernando, and he's definitely a player to be fearful of.
6, 8.
Play by Micaiah. Really strong.
9, 7.
I think Mark really playing a smarter game. Trying to control the point more and forcing errors. Really good effort by both players there. This is going to be a tight match. Micaiah still playing really hot, and I think Mark plays a good style for Micaiah. We'll see what these players come up with in this next round, or in this next game. Trading games in these first two games, and we'll see if we have another 7-game match to view.
Thank you. one each. Skolnick serve for 0-0.
By Mark right there.
Five.
Really coming into his own, and they said he's often a slow starter, but now really taking command of this game.
Mark with four, he's just pushing.
Three, five.
A little bit lucky, but actually a great rally by both players. And 1-1, keeping it really close and forcing Mark to play his best game. Mark can't let Micaiah get too confident hitting those forehand winners. It's like taking away Mark's own forehand. A little bit of a miscalculation. All both players keeping it really tight in this third game. There's Mark's ability and his height kind of helping him reaching and making sure he got that return. Okay, I wasn't even expecting it. Beautiful backhand, forcing Mark into that corner. Game point.
Nine,
you're being up a lot in this last third game. Mark misses his serve and kind of hands the game to Micaiah. Micaiah now leads 2-1 in this best of seven match. And it's interesting to think about what's going through each player's head. For Micaiah, it's important to keep the momentum going and to really not let Mark gain momentum. You know, like Micaiah has to continue playing hard, making those big shots. While for Mark, it's important that he calms down and doesn't make those unforced errors. I think it'd be really important that both players continue to play strategically. See, Mark lost a string of points. It was like a lapse of focus, and we really want him to stay focused if he wants to make it into this final. I know that he's probably really ready to avenge his loss yesterday, and he wants to have this title moving forward. So we'll see how well he can do. And Micaiah really getting Mark out of his comfort zone, playing at a different pace and forcing Mark to react more than stay in control of the point, especially on the forehand counter looping, which should be one of Mark's strengths.
I don't want to play here.
2-1
Staying aggressive and continuing to force Micaiah to rush a little bit. That's what you're seeing, Micaiah trying to calm himself down and stay focused. If you rush, it's very difficult to upset a player. You just make a lot of errors yourself. Keeping the game really, really close. Nice forehand.
No.
Yeah, a little bit of rushing by Micaiah.
6-3
Again, it seems interesting. Both players are making kind of unforced errors. I think they're both nervous and still, even on the second day of play, adjusting to the conditions. And Mark has to get that forehand in if he wants to stay in the game. Once he takes that initiative, it's really hard for Micaiah to come back.
8-4
A little lucky there on that wide serve. Mark has to stay focused to take this game.
And
a little bit of rushing from both players, this time for Mark. Oh, beautiful counter loop. It's really nice and a great confidence booster for Micaiah. Sometimes in these tight games, it's really important to get these confidence-boosting shots to know that you can still make them, so you feel a little bit less hesitant. Nice down-the-line counter loop by Mark, and Micaiah was right there.
7-8
Oh,
good flip.
9-7.
Chole! Come on!
9-8.
Really important point here, both players.
Cool.
Eight, 10.
Oh, good serve. It hasn't served long like that throughout the whole match. It's a good surprise on Mark. Both players staying focused. Mark really needing to take this game. Doesn't want him to go to deuce. Interesting strategy, you know, using that serve again. Usually pretty risky, but this time Mark still wasn't ready.
Yo! Come on, reach!
Changing the rhythm with that slightly spinnier loop gives Mark his third game point. Okay, second block off the table again. Mark has a lot of spin on that loop, and you have to be right there and ready to get it on if you plan on blocking. Here we go. Now we're back at 2-2 again. We've seen a lot of great close matches throughout this tournament, especially since the quarterfinals of the Open Singles event. At 2-2, we could be seeing another really marathon match.
Two.
Middle of the fifth game now. Mark having an early lead and holding on to it.
Cool.
Six, four.
Counter-looping rally.
Show!
Both players really showing their athleticism in this match. Great counter-looping and great changes of speed, angle. You know, it's tough to play a marathon match like this.
Five, seven,
great backhand play by Micaiah.
Five, eight.
Oh, great play. Again, still in the players are great off the table in this power play. Micaiah is really showing that off today.
Come on.
Eight,
I think Mark rushing seven, a little bit. He knows himself too. 8-7. Micaiah coming back a little bit. Mark really needs this point to kind of secure his spot. Really moving Micaiah in and out of the table to get that point and take home that match, or take home that game. The match is obviously not over. As we've seen so many seven-game matches, Micaiah now trails Mark 2-3, and we'll have to see if he can come up with something that allows him to play those big points that he really wants to in the next game. Without winning those big points and, you know, forcing some errors from Mark, it's going to be tough for Micaiah to come back and win this match. Again, nothing is impossible. This is table tennis, so we'll see what happens. Starting off each game with a great rally.
1-0.
And I think at this point, Mark is just edging Micaiah out a little bit. Edging out on some of the rallies and forcing Micaiah to make mistakes. Now it looks like Mark is taking the initiative.
0-2.
All the time. It's really causing some issues for Micaiah.
Yeah, come on,
check. 0-3. Kaya calls a timeout and Mark takes an early 0-3 lead. Checks in with his brother Gabriel, who has played Mark twice this tournament. always with the same 0-4 result, but you know, experience playing a player that your brother is also playing is really good for knowing how that player is feeling just today and at this tournament. What kind of shots will work best? Micaiah taking the time now to refocus and get his head back in the game, figure out how he can win those next points and stay competitive.
Zero, three. What is that?
What is it?
Four. Zero.
Mark keeping his lead and taking some commanding aggressive shots. Mark's looking a lot more confident and moving a lot faster now, and really, you know, playing better as the day goes on. Great block, but didn't make that second one on.
One, five.
Oh, that would be a rush shot. You know, anxiety, some stress. A little bit uncharacteristic mistake.
Oh, come on!
Okay, winning the last 3 points and really putting himself back in the game. Again, it's important from a confidence and mental perspective to not lose, you know, your will to win and feel like you've already lost. Beautiful block by Mark, giving him the opportunity to step around and take that forehand.
Six, three.
Oh, nice backhand attack. Beautiful blocks. Wow, this is a really great point.
Let's go!
Ah,
that's too much.
See, Micaiah rushing. Those are some shots that you see when players mentally rushing, going after too much. Mark just 1 point away from that coveted match point. And there it is. So 6 match points, and this would put him into the final. To get one more point now to make his way into that final. Again, sometimes winning that 1 point is really difficult, so we'll see what happens. It's a little bit of an uphill battle for Micaiah. Beautiful forehand rally and a good way to demonstrate their abilities and book their place to the final. Mark Hazinski moving on. First one to qualify, beating Micaiah Skolnick in the open single semifinals 4-2.